Hey everyone, how's it going? Today, let's take a detailed look at the 2010 Mazda MX-5 Miata Grand Touring. And this is going to be a detailed, in-depth review of the MX-5. We'll start up, show the engine, get an exhaust clipping over the performance data, as well as show you a bunch of the unique aspects of the interior, as well as exterior.
And before we begin, I'd like to give a big thanks and special shout out to South Coast Autos, located in Houston, Texas, for inviting me out to film a wide variety of automobiles and helping support my first ever trip to Texas. For more information about this particular car or other vehicles in their inventory, feel free to check out southcoastautos.com.
And so, without further ado, let's go ahead and start her up, let her run. The MX-5 Grand Touring features an integrated smart key access system, so you can wirelessly lock and unlock the vehicle, just keeping the key fob in your pocket, and locating the little black buttons on the driver and passenger side door handle. To lock it, just tap it once. One beep indicates locking, then after waiting a second, tap the button again. Two beeps indicate unlocking. The door handles are also chrome accented in this model. The exterior color is known as liquid silver metallic, featuring a premium black leather interior. Now, along with the smart key access system, the vehicle also comes with a remote and ignition. Only it's not a push button, but almost like an integrated key mounted into the ignition cylinder. The vehicle will automatically recognize the key fob once you're in the vehicle, so you just put your foot on the brake and clutch, and turn it to start just like you would a normal key. Beautiful. Now, the MX-5 features speed proportional, rack and pinion power steering, and a 3-spoke leather-wrapped steering wheel with satin silver accenting, as well as your multifunction controls on either side. As far as the gearbox, there's a few different options depending on which trim level you get. Now, standard sport models can either be had with a 5-speed manual or a 6-speed automatic with paddle shifters, but in the Touring and Grand Touring, you get an extra gear. It's a 6-speed manual as standard, but you can also opt for the 6-speed automatic with paddle shifters. Nice, crisp, clean, short throws. Push down, all the way over and up for reverse. Accented by the satin silver, as well as a leather shift boot. And so, we've got to flip on the headlamps, fog lamps, as well as the hazards. Both the windows are automatic down. And we'll go check out the exterior, shall we? The vehicle also chimed a few times, letting you know it's lost detection of the proximity key fob.
The Mazda Miata is a small, relatively light rear-wheel drive sports car that's been around for over 20 years now since its first introduction back in 1990. It's always been successful as being a fun, agile, affordable two-seater with a personality reminiscent of classic British nameplates like Triumph, Lotus, MG, and even other nationalities like Datsun and Alfa Romeo. The Miata brings back the fun and exhilaration of those small sports cars, but with modern technology and reliability. The current third generation Miata, or MX-5 as it's commonly referred to now, has been with us now since 2006, and underwent a minor refresh for 2010. It's available in three different trim levels, Sport, Touring, and Grand Touring. The Sport is the quote-unquote base model, but still well equipped with the standard cloth interior, black vinyl convertible top, alloy wheels, etc. As you go up in the trim levels, you not only gain more premium interior materials and luxury features, but also driving enhancements as well, such as strut tower braces, larger wheels, and even an available suspension package only with manual transmissions. It includes a fully tuned suspension with Bilstein shocks and a limited slip differential. The Grand Touring we have here comes loaded with the premium package that takes luxury up a notch, with the addition of just about every enhancement piece you would need for comfort on a day-to-day basis. In addition, Touring and Grand Touring models can also be had with the power retractable hardtop like you see here that replaces the vinyl top. It only adds about 70 pounds to the vehicle's weight, but enhances not only the overall look, but interior quietness and the feeling of refinement. For soft top models, a removable hardtop is available, and soft top models for Touring and Grand Touring are available in alternate colors rather than just black. The 2010 refresh included more angled headlamps, flush rocker panels, protruding rear tail lamps, flared wheel arches that was introduced in 2006, as well as a minute spoiler integrated into the deck lid. Helping improve aerodynamics are wider front and rear bumpers to redirect air away from the spinning tires. The Grand Touring comes standard with larger 17-inch aluminum alloy wheels wrapped in 205/45 performance tires. Four-wheel disc brakes, ventilated in front, it brings the car to a stop from 60 miles an hour in a short 110 feet. Not to mention, features a fully independent suspension consisting of double wishbones in front and a multi-link rear. Overall length is 157.3 inches with a width of 67.7 inches and a height of 47 inches. Total curb weight, depending on your trim level and equipment packages, is just over 2,500 pounds.
And we're going to pop the hood.
The MX-5 receives a 2-liter, dual-overhead cam, all-aluminum 16-valve 4-cylinder that produces 167 horsepower at 7,000 RPM and 140 pound-feet of torque at 5,000 RPM. Power decreases slightly for the automatic transmission models. This translates to a 0-60 time of around 6.6 seconds and a quarter mile time of 15 seconds at 91 miles per hour. As far as fuel economy, with a 12.7 gallon tank and required premium fuel, expect a rating in the neighborhood of around 21 city, 28 highway. The interior of the MX-5 is very simple overall. There's not a whole lot of optional accessories aside from upgrading seating and other materials, along with a premium audio system. The standard interior is sporty and has stayed pretty true to its origins, keeping basic styling aspects but modernizing it for technology and safety upgrades. There's soft material in the touch points across the doors with color accent stitching and padding in the center console. Power locks and mirrors are located on the door, while the windows are located in the center console as I showed earlier. There's also a bit of storage in the lower door panels. As far as the seating, the Grand Touring comes standard with leather-wrapped sport bucket seats with color accent white stitching, manual adjustment as well as manual height adjustment for the driver's seat. You also have side airbags, and feature a nice amount of lateral grip down below and across the back with a little bit of side bolstering. Aluminum logo door sill plaques, as well as an interior accented completely by satin silver accent and giving a little bit more of a sporty touch to it.
So let's go and see how she sounds. Top back up. There's two buttons located up here, one up and one down off to the right. Just press it and hold. The clamshell pulls up and the hard top is released. And then to bring it back down, press this little release button here. Pull the clasp back out. A little LED indicator will show you that the top isn't secure. And then hit the down button. And we're gonna shut her up. Now, as you'd expect out of the Grand Touring, it comes with pretty much every option available for the MX-5, including a premium Bose sound system fed through an in-dash CD player, MP3 compatible with iPod auxiliary integration, as well as standard Sirius satellite radio. Auto-dimming rear view mirror with integrated garage home link, and up above, your interior illumination. The radio itself is really easy to use. Up top, all of your different radio modes, you have your presets across each side, as well as your other radio functions like seek, changing the track, changing the disc, tune, pretty much your standard radio controls. Off to the right, with the tune button, when you click it, you have your speed compensated volume, equalizer settings, changing your clock settings, and the like. Like I said, very simple. Down below that is your electronic automatic climate control with your different zones over here, front and rear defrost, automatic all the way over to the left, temperature, recycling, as well as fan speed. Down below that are 5-stage heated seats for the driver and passenger, your auxiliary input, as well as a 12-volt power outlet next to that. As you come down the center console, your power windows like you saw earlier, little padded center console here that slides out into a bunch of storage. As well as some extra storage cubbies back here, it's also lockable. When you fold the seat up, you'll see a little storage pocket on the back, but that's just about it as far as storage behind the seat. Glass rear window with a rear window defroster, as well as a little windscreen to cut down some of the excess buffeting while going at higher speeds down the road. There's also two speakers mounted in between the passengers, so it feels a little bit more like a surround sound feeling. As far as the steering wheel, your lighting and turn signal is off to the left, your intermittent wipers is off to the right, cruise control, radio controls, as well as hands-free telephone and voice dialing. Help.
Available options are call, dial, redial, phone book, emergency, voice training, or setup, or say cancel to exit.
Cancel. So, you pair that with your hands-free Bluetooth telephone, then you can store your contacts and call it that way if you desire. But it's actually a pretty pleasant voice. It doesn't really sound robotic or computer-generated like some of the other systems do. But that's pretty much it for the interior. Very simplistic. So I'm gonna shut her down. Yeah, we'll check out the rest of the vehicle, shall we?
As you would expect, the MX-5 features around 5.3 cubic feet of cargo space, modest, but it is a smaller car. It's also illuminated, and enough spaces for a couple bags, enough groceries, as well as the vehicle's car cover. The passenger seat also features manual adjustment, but minus the height adjustment that the driver's side has.
modest lockable glove box, as well as a little cup holder in the pocket of the door. Well, everyone, I hope you enjoyed this detailed look at the 2010 Mazda MX-5 Miata Grand Touring. Be sure to stay tuned next time. There's a lot more where that came from. Take care, everybody.